Hello, welcome. Here's my top 10 recommendations for building a reading list for cyber threat intelligence. So coming in at number 10 is Malignant's APT1. This is an old report now, but it's still really that benchmark that you're trying to exceed if you're talking about advanced persistent threat and the relationships between states and hacking organizations. It was exciting when it came out. It's still pretty relevant even now, even though a lot of the technology has moved on within that report. Definitely worth a look to see the heritage of where we've come from. On that note, coming in at number 9 is The Dark Visitor by Scott J. Henderson. So this was before even the word Advanced Persistent Threat, or APT, was even well known within the nascent cybersecurity community. This work talks a lot and expands upon the scope that's covered in APT1 by talking about Honker Union and those kind of real old school OG hacktivist collectives that started working with the Chinese state back in the day. Again, this is knocking around on the internet. You can find it in various kind of locations. But again, it's kind of paying homage to where modern CTI came from, and you should check it out. Something a bit more theoretical at number 8 is Thomas Ridd's War 2.0. Thomas Ridd is a rightly respected academic within the world of cyber threat intelligence, and this is just one of his many books. But for me, it's definitely one of his most relevant works, because it takes that broader view on where cyber threat actually sits within a wider context and practice of warfare. So if you're trying to understand this idea of asymmetry or irregular warfare or guerrilla warfare and things like that, and how that maps to cyber, this is really like a really, really good starting point. Obviously, some of Thomas Ridd's works, this is Cyber War Will Not Take Place, definitely overshadow War 2.0, but for me, the longevity is more in War 2.0 than some of his other works, which are also great. You should also check those out. Okay, if all that got a bit heavy, then let's have a bit of a break with Neuromancer coming in at number 7. So this is a complete work of fiction by William Gibson, a great, great sort of dystopian cyberpunk author. But Neuromancer got many people into cybersecurity and computer hacking just all on its own, even though at the time it's talking about a world that was strangely out of reach, but kind of coming. And it sort of really does paint this kind of image of the world. Great starting point, and also part of that kind of common culture that we kind of know inside the cybersecurity arena. Again, just to sort of update this, Ernst Klein's Ready Player One, in my view, just my personal view, is kind of a good update really on Neuromancer, and taking a lot of those ideas and updating them into something that you can see. So for example, there's a big data leak inside Ready Player One that you don't necessarily see in Neuromancer. But again, let's get back to something a bit more tangible and a bit more theoretical. And at number 6 is a joint entry. And we're going to talk about two papers at this point. One is the ever catchily titled Intelligence-Driven Computer Network Defense Informed by Analysis of Adversary Campaigns and Intrusion Kill Chains. Catchy. And the other one is the Diamond Model of Intrusion Analysis. So even though these sound quite dry papers, they actually introduce two absolutely critical components of modern cyber threat intelligence, that being the Lockheed Martin Kill Chain and the Diamond Model of Intrusion Analysis that you use to link together kill chains. The papers themselves are actually a lot more interesting than they might sound. They give a very clear explanation of the theory behind these two ideas of the kill chain and the diamond model that really have built kind of an industry off the back end of those. So they're absolutely required reading in my view. Coming in now at number 5 is Intelligence Analysis Target Centric Approach by Robert N. Clark. So this isn't actually CTI specific. This is more kind of a general kind of analysis kind of approach. But what it does is put forward this idea of a target centric analysis approach. And that's absolutely kind of critical to modern cyber threat intelligence. If you've ever touched something like Multigo or IBM I2 Analyst Notebook, you're doing target centric analysis. You just might not even know it. It's worth a look at, and it's worth understanding the nuances of that as Clark kind of puts forward in this work. Okay, coming in at number 4 is something that's quite a bit more up to date, and that's the History of Revel. Along with having probably the best title in my view and book cover of any of the works within this list, it's a masterful piece of research. It's really scintillating, it's really long. It'll take a long time to plow through this work, but Mr. DiMaggio goes to town really on what cyber threat intelligence analysts can do, and combines that kind of obsessive, almost gumshoe type approach to looking into a subject and researching it that I know and love, with the more technical aspects as well, and presents it in an amazing way. So again, if kind of APT1 was sort of the starting point, this is definitely a waymark along that route of what can be achieved, and also focusing on cybercrime, not nation states. So again, showing that kind of shift as things go on. Getting a bit more theoretical now at number three is Tim Moore's Cyber Mercenaries, State Hackers and Power. Again, more kind of theoretical work, but an important work as well, because it outlines this new kind of cyber threat actor, which is the cyber mercenary. Again, sort of talked about in William Gibson's Neuromancer, but these are essentially guns for hire by anybody that will sort of pay for it. And he goes through these in great detail. So it provides you with a more depth than just knowing about the three kind of classic threat actors, which is nation state, cyber criminal, and cyber activists. This will nuance it, and this shows you those actors that are sitting inside those grey areas. Another entry is number two. At number two is Cyber Threat Intelligence, a Product Without a Process. Pretty uncomfortable paper to read, actually, because essentially what it's talking about is that gap between the sort of the expectation of cyber threat intelligence and what cyber threat intelligence is delivering. And critically, this allows you to start to develop an answer to the question of how is cyber threat intelligence actionable, and taking that critical view on your own professional practice. There's many, many points in this paper, but one of the things that I really like is it says that, you know, cyber threat intelligence is a pretty new discipline. It's new to the party, and there's a lot of work that can be done. It's building out frameworks and building out rigor in that area as well. So again, kind of uncomfortable reading, but something that I think we should all be aware of. Okay, now coming in at number one is Richard J. Hughes, Psychology of an Intelligence Analyst. For those of you that are observant, you'll see the Diamond Model of Intrusion Analysis was actually introduced with a quote by Richard J. Hughes. Hughes is an absolute legend within the intelligence analysis community, and he's kind of the starting point for many people's careers. Interestingly enough, he's not particularly cyber specific. He's written on cyber, but you know, his more approach is that of a sort of general analyst, and you can apply a lot of the things that he's talking about to any kind of field of intelligence analysis. There's lots of great stuff in this book, but the main thing that's in this book, almost tucked away, is his approach, which is called the analysis of competing hypotheses, or the ACH approach. This is kind of the power tool for critically evaluating complex situations inside any threat intelligence scenario, and especially inside of cyber threat intelligence. It's one of those key things alongside the Diamond Model and the kill chain. So to be honest, this deserves its slot at number one, and you know, I hope you'll appreciate that. Okay, that kind of concludes my top 10 reads for getting into cyber threat intelligence. Thank you.